It takes a lot of hard work to become a billionaire, and the current generation of young billionaires have done so at the age of 30 or younger. Here are the 10 billionaires varying from an 18-year-old pharmacy heir to the founders of food delivery firm DoorDash and electric vehicle components company Luminar. Let's get started. Number 10. Jonathan Kwok. Jonathan Kwok, the youngest son of renowned estate magnate Walter Kwok, is a director at Empire Group Holdings, where he oversees the company's real estate assets, development of the project, and asset management functions. Walter Kwok died in 2018, but before that, he had resigned as chairman of SHKP due to the disagreement with his two brothers, Raymond and Thomas, and went on to found the Empire Group, a real estate firm. However, the former chairman's holdings in SHKP were passed down to Jonathan and his brother, Joffrey. Their grandmother, Kwong Si Hing, the widow of SHKP co-founder Kwok Tek Sing, has carefully selected the brothers as recipients of one-third of five trust funds. Jonathan's net worth is estimated to be $2.4 billion. Number 9. Sam Bankman-Fried. Sam Bankman-Fried, who runs the FTX exchange and the Alameda research trading business, is the richest person in crypto at 29 years of age. With a net worth of $8.7 billion, he's the son of two Stanford law professors. He studied physics at MIT but was driven to effective altruism, the utilitarian ineffected idea of doing the most good possible. So he went to work for a quaint firm, trading ETFs, donating a portion of his salary to charity, and then jumped into crypto trading in late 2017, after spotting a lucrative arbitrage opportunity. In 2019, Bankman-Fried created his own exchange, FTX. It's one of the most popular exchanges for buying and selling crypto derivatives, having built ByTraders for traders, and in July 2021, FTX received $900 million at an $18 billion valuation from investors, including Coinbase Ventures and SoftBank, making Bankman-Fried one of the wealthiest individuals under 30 in history. The majority of his fortune is related to his ownership of roughly half of FTX and a share of its FTT tokens, which he claims he will eventually contribute to charity based on the concept he calls earning to give. Number 8. Stanley Tang. DoorDash's co-founder and chief product officer is Stanley Tang. He studied computer science at Stanford University and graduated with a bachelor's degree. He was born in Hong Kong and currently resides in the United States. Tang is 28 years old and has a net worth of $2.6 billion. During the epidemic, DoorDash, the meal delivery service co-founder by Fang and Tang, in 2013 became more popular and lucrative than ever as restaurants and consumers shifted to delivery. In December, it went public on the New York Stock Exchange. Tang was the company's chief product officer while Fang was the company's chief technical officer. Number 7. Andy Fang. Andy Fang is a Chinese-American billionaire internet entrepreneur. He's best known for co-founding and serving as chief technology officer of DoorDash, a company he co-founded with Stanley Tang in 2013. He's 28 years old and has a net worth of $2.6 billion, just like his other co-founder. Fang was born and raised in San Francisco Bay Area, where he graduated from the Harker School in 2010. Fang graduated from Stanford University with a bachelor's degree in computer science. He previously worked as a CS106 section leader at Stanford University before co-founding DoorDash. He owns around 4% of stakes in DoorDash, which went public on the New York Stock Exchange in early December 2020. Number 6. Gustav Magnar Witzo. Gustav Magnar Witzo, age 27, has a net worth of $4.4 billion and is the heir of SalMar ASA, one of the world's largest salmon producers, which was created by his father, Gustav Witzo, in 1991. SalMar, one of the world's leading manufacturers of organic salmon, is owning 53.4% by the Witzo family's financial arm, Cuerva. Scottish Sea Farms run aqua farms in Scotland, while Arnarlax HF has aqua farms in Iceland. To avoid a huge inheritance tax, his father handed him a 47% interest in SalMar when he was 19 years old. The senior Witzo is still in charge of the day-to-day operations of the Norwegian fish farm firm, which operates in both the center and northern areas of the nation. Gustav, along with two Norwegian sister duo Alexandra and Katharina Andersen, became the world's three youngest billionaires as a result of their inherited riches. Witzo, who formerly worked for MGM Property, has established a reputation as an angel investor in the information and technology industry, where he invests in both companies and real estate. The heir to the Norwegian salmon dynasty has a hefty investment portfolio, having backed businesses such as Gobi, a Snapchat rival created by students, and Key Butler, a tool for Airbnb hosts. Number 5. Austin Russell. Austin Russell, a college dropout, is the founder and CEO of Luminar Technologies. an automotive sensor company that went public in December 2020 through an SPAC merger. Russell, an optics genius, came up with the concept of luminar while studying physics at Stanford University when he was 17 years old. After winning a $100,000 Thiel Fellowship, a program financed by billionaire Peter Thiel to encourage entrepreneurs, he dropped out of college in 2012. Russell became the world's youngest self-made billionaire at the age of 25 after Luminar was listed on NASDAQ. Luminar competes with laser lidar manufacturers such as Velodyne and Aeva, who produce high-tech sensors to let self-driving cars see their surroundings. Number 4. Katharina Anderson. Katharina Anderson, who was born in 1995 and has a net worth of $1.4 billion, is among the world's youngest billionaires. She and her younger sister, Alexandra, both received 42% of the family-owned investment firm, Ferd. Anderson was fined $27,000 in November 2017 for drunken driving. Anderson's blood alcohol level was 3 times the permissible amount. The punishment also included a 13-month license suspension in addition to the fine. She announced in 2019 that she will be relocating to London, England. Johan, the girl's father, still manages the firm and has a dual-class share structure that gives him 70% of the votes. Ferd manages hedge funds, participates in the Nordic Stock Exchange, and invests in private equity. Number 3. Alexandra Anderson. Alexandra Gamlemskog Anderson, a Norwegian heiress, was born on July 23, 1996. At the age of 19, she had become the world's youngest billionaire, and she has been on Forbes' list as the world's youngest billionaire for 3 consecutive years. Anderson's net worth is expected to be $1.4 billion as of 2021, making her the world's 3rd youngest billionaire. Despite her privileged background, she isn't your average rich kid. Anderson is a skilled horse rider who works for a German dressage stable. Despite her billion-dollar fortune, she saves the majority of her pocket money and has only driven secondhand automobiles since she was a teenager. Anderson has received several prizes and honors in horse dressage contests, and she's posed for the equestrian apparel business Kingsland on various occasions. Number 2. Wang Xiaolong. Wang Xiaolong, a Chinese entrepreneur, was born in 1997 and was named one of Forbes magazine's World's Richest Young People in 2021. Wang Xiaolong was born in the country of China. The young millionaire is only 25 years old, yet he's already got a net worth of $2.1 billion. He's the 2nd youngest billionaire on Forbes' World's General List and the youngest in all of Asia. Even though nothing is known about him or his life, it's believed that he's married and that his assets originate from the chemical industry, specifically from CNNC, Huayuan Titanium Dioxide and Lomon Billions Group, both of which produce titanium dioxide in China. Titanium dioxide is a chemical that can be found in a variety of sectors, including medicines, personal hygiene products, paints, ceramics. The billionaire now resides in the Chinese city of Jiaozhou. Number 1. Kevin David Lehmann. Kevin David Lehmann, an 18-year-old German, is the world's youngest billionaire, according to Forbes' list of the world's billionaires under 30. Lehmann's fortune is attributed to his stakes in his father's drugstore chain, DM Droguerie Market, according to Forbes. Lehmann controls at least 50% of the firm's value, which is more than $3.6 billion, and the company operates almost 2,000 shops across Germany, employing 41,000 people. Despite not being actively involved in the drugstore business, Lehmann became a billionaire at an early age. Surprisingly, the kid billionaire does not have a social media account and only appears in public on rare occasions. Forbes stated that the 18-year-old billionaire's father, Günther Lehmann, handed his son a portion in German pharmacy chain Droguerie Market, where he was 14, but it stayed under custodianship until his 18th birthday. When Lehmann turned 18 in September 2020, he became a trustee for the business. That wraps today's video. Thank you for watching all the way to the conclusion of this video. And please remember to like, comment, and subscribe to our channel. We'll see you in the next one. In the meantime, take care. Goodbye.